Welcome to your French class. Our today's topic is les pronoms relatifs simple. Here we have two words, qui and que. These two words are basically pronouns and their function is to relate or join two sentences meaningfully. Hence, they are called relative pronouns. Okay. So we basically join them in between two different sentences and we make it a complete statement. Okay. A single statement. Now, qui means who and which. Okay. For person, obviously, if you are using qui, it will be giving the sense of who, and for things, which. And que, for person, it will be giving sense of whom and who, and for things, that and which. Now, these two pronouns we are using to replace what? Qui replaces subjects and que replaces direct objects. Okay. Now, let's take the first statement. C'est mon ami Manuel. Manuel travaille au Japon. Now, I don't want to repeat Manuel again in my second statement. This was the first one. This is the second one. I don't want to repeat Manuel again and again. So what I'm going to do is I want to use here a pronoun instead this noun. I want to use a pronoun here. So let's see how we'll do this. C'est mon ami Manuel. This is my friend Manuel. The same line that was written here. Manuel travaille au Japon. Manuel works in Japan. Now, I have written the first sentence as it is because first time here I'm talking about Manuel. Now I'm repeating Manuel again in my second statement and here I'm using instead a pronoun. Okay. C'est mon ami Manuel. This is my friend Manuel. Dash. Here I need to write a pronoun. Travaille au Japon. Now, if in English I complete this statement, I'll speak it like this is my friend Manuel who works in Japan. Now, who means qui. Okay. And the second way to memorize this function is whenever after the blank there is a verb given, you need to write qui. Okay. It works in 80% of the cases. And whenever there is a noun or a subject or a pronoun is given after the blank, then you need to write here que. Okay. So, c'est mon ami Manuel, dash travaille au Japon. This is my friend Manuel who works in Japan. So for who I'm taking qui. And the second way, I have already told you after the blank, there is a verb. I need to write qui because qui is a subject here. Okay. Second one, c'est mon livre. This is my book. J'apporte ce livre à l'école tous les jours. This is my book. I bring this book to the school daily. Now, I don't want to repeat ce livre again in my sentence. Book word I don't want to repeat. So, what I'm going to do is, c'est mon livre. This is my book. Now, here, I'm talking about the book. So, I'm keeping a blank here to fill it with a pronoun. J'apporte à l'école tous les jours. I bring to the school daily. Now, if in English I need to fill this blank, how I will fill it? This is my book. Now here, which or that I take to school daily. Now here, after the blank, there is a subject given. So I need to write here a direct object. I need to replace a direct object. Mon livre is a direct object here. So I'm replacing it with que. Okay, now let's see some more sentences. First statement, n'achète pas la chemise d'achète trop long. Don't buy the shirt which is too long. Now, here after the blank, we are having a verb. So, we'll write here qui because we are talking about a subject here. Don't buy the shirt which is too long. Now, the second one, les enfants dash jouent au tennis ne veulent pas rentrer. The children dash are playing tennis, don't want to come back. Again, the children who are playing tennis. Now again, after the blank, there is a verb. And here we are talking about again the subject. So, qui. Les enfants qui jouent. The children who are playing tennis ne veulent pas rentrer, don't want to come back. The third one, l'histoire dash tu m'as raconté n'est pas vraie. The story dash you told me is not true. Now, After the blank, there is a pronoun given, a subject. So we are going to write here girl, because here we are talking about a direct object. Okay. Now, l'histoire que tu m'as racontée n'est pas vraie. The story that you told me is not true. Number 4. La prof dash monsign s'appelle Monsieur Vincent. The professor or the teacher, the professor dash teaches me is called, or his name is Mr. Vincent, means Vincent. Now, again, after the blank, here I'm having a verb. Okay. I'm having a verb here. So, I will write qui. As-tu aimé les chansons dash tu as écouté? Did you like the songs dash you heard? Now, again, here I am talking about the direct object. And second thing, after the blank, I am having here a pronoun. So, I'll write que. As-tu aimé les chansons? Did you like the songs that you heard? Que tu as écouté? C'est le gâteau dash ma mère a préparé. This is the cake dash my mother prepared. Now, this is the cake. Here we are talking about the cake. And ma mère is a noun here. And here I will write que. This is the cake that my mother prepared. So this was all about les pronoms relatifs simple, qui and que. If you need to ask anything more about, do ask me. Thank you.